When you hear some of the stories I've heard, you hear some of the harshest cruelty humans can inflict on other humans, you know? And you need faith to get through that. Once we decided to retire and move here to Denton, Texas, which I thought was going to be this sleepy little community without a lot of crime in it, the year we moved here, there were 4 front page articles on human trafficking groups that were convicted in our county. It just really hit me, you know, just how common human trafficking is in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, especially. And so I began researching, you know, just how bad is this? That's when I put together a program to teach the public, and I presented it to Sandra Schrader, now the federal government coordinator. And she said, yes, by all means. She thought that it was worthy of educating the public, our parishioners, about this. And so I began doing that throughout the diocese. I noticed that there was an incredible number of young people who disclosed their sexual abuse in the military, and it just really struck me how common it seemed, and that was part of my impetus, I guess, for doing something that would, you know, help the Catholic faith and the parishioners understand just how common this problem is. And I guess I wanted to cast my net a little wider and influence a greater number of people and talk about the prevention, the detection, and what you need to do once you suspect something. Because I do think it's a very difficult topic for a lot of people to talk about. The estimated 750,000 traffickers of the world have access to all of our homes through the internet. And so what can we do as responsible parents to make sure and put as many filters and monitoring systems in place so that we are able to detect it early, educate our kids about it in age-appropriate ways, and then what to do once we figure out something has happened. Feedback that I get from the individuals that, you know, I do present to, people talk about how they simply did not know how rampant it was, the grooming process of sexual predators. They don't know the signs to look for in a child and then what to do if they suspect something. And understanding that there are far more resources today than there had been, gosh, even 5 years ago. One, because it's growing at the rate that it is. It's the fastest growing illegal enterprise in the world. We have to have the shareholders in place to deal with the entire problem that we're having today. We need to go and deal with the larger picture and educate the masses. Because if we don't, the numbers are only going to continue to increase. There's an old saying about we concentrate all of our efforts in pulling people out of a river where they're drowning. If we don't go to the mouth of the river and keep them from falling in the first place, we're never going to solve the problem. And that's always really stuck with me.